Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Jill of the Jungle! Today is episode 3, well, the beginning of it anyways. Jill saves the prince! They're starting off strong with their music game. So yeah, let's go ahead and get in here before— oh wow. Taking some serious inspiration from Keen here, we have a world map, and we enter the valley. So let's see, we gotta hear what the jump sound is. It's good. Okay, alright. Apples give us health, we know this. She hits the ground and it's like a gunshot. Oh my lord. Oh, this game. Tim Sweeney, what are you doing? Okay, so we have obvious knife is obvious. We want that. What the fuck was that? Like, we pick up the knife and the T-Rex roars. Alright. Jeez, every time we throw it. Well, that's not gonna get obnoxious at all. Well, I mean, I guess we can go ahead and save here. Oh, this is so weird. Like, I just realized I've been saving these as, like, 01, 02 every time, but we're on, like, episode 5 now, I think? God, the sound design is just so bad. Alright, so what is this? We need to hit 5 levers, perhaps? I don't know, we'll see. Oh, maybe just one lever. I don't know how in-depth this one is. I mean, we got a world map now, you guys. This is a big bit of advancement. Oh, that was interesting. They disappeared as we approached them. Back to the jungle map. Alright. So we need a gem over there. Again, like the... I don't think this looks bad. Like, the overland map, it's a bit superfluous, I think. At least at this point. But it looks okay. Like, for all that I... God, that is terrible. For all this game's faults, it doesn't look bad. And it really doesn't play bad. It's just super straightforward. Like, they're not doing anything here. Well, I should say they're not doing anything you haven't seen elsewhere. Although, I take that back. You know, you got, like, the little transformation, such as it is. And the, you know, absolute god-tier sound design here. Wow, throwing the fucking devil at us in the very beginning of the game, and I think he's maybe immune to my knife. Because I'm pretty sure... Dude's immune to stabbings. Alright, fair enough. Okay, I don't know what the point of this is. He's just here to eat my hit points. Begone, Jesus Christ. Alright, so don't go up. Satan ain't playing. Well, in that case... I guess we're going over here. I never realized that he was immune to knives. I wonder if, like, you can only hurt him. I guess the only other times we fought him was with the spinning blade. God, that sound effect is so bad. Oh my lord. Seriously, nothing up here. Don't know that I'm necessarily the biggest fan of this troll level design. I mean, at least they're throwing some slightly more advanced stuff at us here in the very beginning. Like, I'm appreciative of that. As I've mentioned previously, I felt these games have been up to this point fairly easy, so I'm not gonna... We don't get the yeah anymore when we get keys. My experience is ruined. Tim Sweeney, I hope you burn in the darkest pit of the abyss. For getting rid of the yeah sound effect when you get key. Why would you do that? Is the most redeeming sound effect in the entire game. Because, I mean, like, everybody's happy to get a key, so of course you pick up a key and yeah, but no. Now we don't get anything. We get, like, a little crash. And T-Rex sounds when we grab a knife. What is this? My... and the doors fart at us. And somebody sneezes when you grab a gem. Oh my lord. This game. I just can't get over this world map and just how absolutely pointless it is. We journey to the dam. Oh, spinning blade. What sound effect do we have with this? Oh, that's decidedly tame. Alright. I don't know how to feel about this. Okay, so we have chain to go down. Well, but I have to know, like... Oh, I thought it was gonna be something interesting. I have to say, the sound design in this game, like, it reminds me there was this old... I wouldn't say DOS, like, Windows 3.1 thereabouts. It was actually also on the... God, it would have been the old Macs. Like, old Macintosh computers. And it was called Realms. It was spelt with a Z. Alright. And the sound design and just how, like, kind of... jank as fuck it is here very much reminds me of that game. Huh. Alright, so I don't know what we're supposed to do here, but we cannot proceed. Yet. Maybe we have to fall. We'll see. But yeah, like the... Alright. Oh god, is that bees? It's bees. Ah, not the bees! They're in my eyes! Fuck off, bees. Oh, and frogs. This place is just full-on, like, horrible. But, yeah, the sound design in this very much kind of reminds me of that, where it's just, like, a lot of what... Like, they probably just found in some... Eh? Ah, they probably just found it in, like, some... Ah, that's death! Ooh, I almost killed myself there. They probably just found it in, like, some random user group online and are like, well, I guess we'll use this. And, like, some of it works okay, and then some of it just sounds really, really bad. But Realms was actually a pretty decent RPG. It was, like, a turn-based... Kind of like the old Gold Box games, but no first-person viewpoint to, like, dungeon exploration. That game was, like, fucking deep, and it had, like, a scenario maker for it and stuff, too, that was pretty interesting. I don't even know if it runs on computers anymore. I doubt it does. You'd probably need to, like, emulate... Ow. You'd probably need to, like, emulate Windows 3.1, like, run it on a virtual machine or install it on DOSBox. Okay, so we have the extra... Alright, we have the extra jumping power. Let's see what we can get to. I'd love to say that one day I will show off Realms, but I don't know. I can't say never, but that would probably be a challenge. But it was a pretty cool game. I think it's now like freeware, because I don't think you can buy it anymore. You just gotta find a copy. I think they actually have it on the original website, and they gave you like the codes, because the game had like a shitload of custom scenarios you could buy. So I'm sure. Oh, bees. I gotta be careful, like, we're hurting pretty bad here. Alright, fuck bees. So that's maybe one day. I don't know, we'll see. I remember it had a lot of classes, and like some really weird ones. But I played the shit out of that game back in the day, the shareware version, because I was young and poor and couldn't afford the full version. But man, it was pretty cool. Seriously, game? You're trolling. Alright, so then I have to probably go over to where those bees were. I think that's like the only... Oh, the only progress that can be expected, unless there's something up here. It does feel like... Aw, is this... anything? Oh, there's something up there. But it does feel like they're making this a little bit more challenging, which I can get on board with. Like, I'm all for some... Will we kill ourselves? No. I'm all for more difficult levels. Because, like, I don't mind playing this game, but up to this point it has been very, very easy. So if they wanna... Oh, seriously, you're not gonna let me jump that? If they wanna get a little soul-crushy, I'm okay with that. You know, make the last episode kind of a bit of a trial. Just keeping an eye out. Okay, so I'm gonna save. I'm curious why some of these birds are just, like, hanging out. I wonder if that's... I don't know. So what, then I guess we have to jump left, right? Because I saw that. And it says, it's an arrow pointing down. All right. How the heck to play? Thanks, game, for finally telling me how to move. Oh, we're underwater now. That's... Okay. I'm not gonna question anything about this game. Oh, I don't trust this, but no. Maximum fear, alright, so that'll kill us. There's nothing else. This level design is very different. Like, it feels like this was developed, the map was developed by someone else. Alright, so we are now the bird, and water will kill us as I almost touch the water. Okay. Oh, that's what this little hole was for, so we can fly out. Oh, all right, and now I gotta go up, right? Yeah, because this will turn us human. But can I just skip it? I can! We enter the jungle map. Hey, I should be a bird right now. Okay, so is it... All right, so we have a level there. Have we finally hit, like, maybe just a little bit of open world exit? Yes, we have. All right. I wonder if there are, like, secret passages in the woods. That would be cool if there were hidden levels. So we bound into the airy. Okay, so we can... Alright, so these are platforms. Those are... I guarantee you guys I'm gonna be missing these things because they don't look like platforms. The music is... Like, this track isn't too bad. It's a little... A little trippy, but it actually kind of all things, reminds me of wizardry. I'll be asked if I could tell you why. Of World Epic Games. It's a world of something. I'll agree to that. I cannot tell you how disappointed I am by them getting rid of the yeah sound effect for picking up keys. Like, that has been kind of like the highlight of this Let's Play as far as I'm concerned. Wild and weird. Oh, it's the weird and wild world of Epic Games. Ugh. Just ew. I know that you gotta, you know, advertise your brand. I get that, but, like, fuck, come on. Although, I guess this was kind of like the Wild West of shareware, right? So, I don't know. Maybe this is normal. You gotta get that. I mean, look at it. It's obviously worked for them. They're, like, a fucking huge company now. Let's see here. They changed how this bouncing blade works, I think. Like, it feels like it functions differently to how it used to. Not that I'm complaining. Oh, we have an elevator. Alright. Up! Because, of course, that's the sound elevators make. I think that says epic. Video games. I'm curious how long this fucking ant needs to die. There we go. I'm curious how long this one is. Oh, we got a jump power up. Compared to... Seriously, game, you're gonna give me a jump power up right at the end of the level. Seriously, game. You're gonna do me like that. Oh my lord. Oh, I don't know. It would be nice if they gave me some way to know... I'm gonna save. Can we go back in? No. Okay, I was gonna say, it'd be nice if they gave me some indicator as to knowing what levels we've done, but I guess this is before such a time as that concept has even, you know, entered the ship of the giant green lizard man. Is she still... Yeah, she still jumps. So I'm curious. All right. We are entering a ship. Oh my. Little Godzillas. Look at him go. Alright. Whoop. Nope. Oh my god, the movement. Jill. It's my pro pad. It's betraying me. I think this is actually probably going to be the last game we're going to be able to play with the pro pad. Now that I think about it, I don't think Realms of Chaos will play too well, honestly. I'm fairly certain that game is going to require more than two buttons. Believe me, I am as sad as all of you. Oh, this is starting to feel a little bit like fucking Burger Time right here. I hate Burger Time. That's probably like one of my least favorite games. I know it was an arcade game, but I played it on the Nintendo, and I hated every damn minute of it. These guys, I was gonna say they do speed up. All right, yeah, they start off slow, but when they see you, they start moving a little faster. I can dig that. Sure, why not? God, that key sound is just, ew. Oh, do you turn around? Or is that just how far you move? Oh, no, they turn around after a while. Interesting. Different AI. Oh, shit. And we have... Oh my god, fuck you, dude. Nope, nope, nope. Alright, so I mean, I obviously want that... Oh, this is like... I just say I can get it, it's just bullshit. Oh my god, Jill. There we go. This is likewise bullshit. But for different reasons. Ooh. Alright. We have two crystals. I'm gonna save. Whew. I will admit, this is... Oh my god, just run for it. This is a little bit more challenging. Oh, we're missing one. Hmm. We do have a key. Maybe earlier in the level? Yep, right down here. Oh, and thankfully, they're giving me a bunch of apples, which we pretty dearly need, because the placement on these guys is not impossible to avoid, but very difficult. It is certainly almost beyond me. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and save again. His music isn't bad. It's something that I could see getting annoying, but it's not bad. It's like got a nice little menacing tune to it. Oh, is that? All right. We enter the jungle map. Well, that was a thing. But I do think we're going to go ahead and call it here. So as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. I hope you all had a good time. And I will see you all next time, wherein Jill's attempt to save the prince continues. Until then.